Hi friends, my name is Chaitanya Patke and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to analyze the final group game of the group stages between Pakistan and Hong Kong. Pakistan ran riot over Hong Kong, I would say. They weren't in the game Hong Kong right from the onset, and Pakistan were too good, too strong and too heavy for them. Although it is a learning experience for Hong Kong, but it is actually a very painful one. And it is an experience that they won't forget, but they have to put it behind themselves and take the lesson from this thrashing, because I find no other word in describing such performance by Hong Kong. Although Pakistan were miles ahead, we already knew that, but I at least expected some resistance from Hong Kong, because as we know that they came through qualifying in a very difficult circumstances, and they put a very more than creditable showing against India, but it all came crashing down. Hong Kong won the toss and one chose to ball. I think if they batted first, at least the margin of victory could have been a little bit lower, but it wasn't meant to be. Anyways, the match took place at Sharjah. Hong Kong chose to bowl. Pakistan managed 193 for 2 in their 20 allotted 20 overs, with Mohammad Rizwan scoring 78 of 57 deliveries. He was adjudged the man of the match. Although many people will say that his strike rate is a little bit low, but we have to take into consideration that the pitch was a little bit too paced on the slower side, and hence he took his time. And he calculated the number of balls remaining perfectly well, and he said in the post-match presentation that he took the attack towards the Hong Kong bowler at the start of the 11th over, and it was a conscious effort by him to play straight after the first half of the Pakistan innings, which was pretty much evident in his batting. So it shows that his head is very sorted. And yes, he has scored the most number of international runs since the last 1.5 years in international cricket. Nobody has scored more than him. He was also the ICC International Cricketer of the Year last year. So he makes sense, and he approached his innings very well. He took singles and he converted ones into twos, and he ran between the wickets pretty well, even though he was not able to find the boundaries at his will in the first 10 overs. He more than made it up by especially playing straight, because as we know that his predominant scoring area is towards the leg side, but he just curbed his instincts, and his shots were behind the wicket as well. He employed the sweep to a greater effect, and his late cut was also pretty effective, which confused the Hong Kong spinners towards the latter part of their innings. Babar Azam unfortunately has continued his poor form. He scored 9 of 8 deliveries. Ehsan Khan also got him out in the Asia Cup previously in 2018, and he also got him out now. So a big scalp for Ehsan Khan as well. Fakhar Zaman, his long levers were working pretty nicely this game. 53 of 41 deliveries, which includes 3 boundaries and 2 maximum, especially those huge sixes. His trademark over deep mid wicket. He would have been disappointed because he wanted to carry out a little bit longer, but Khushdil Shah towards the end more than made up for it. 4 sixes in the final over, 35 of 15 deliveries, which included 5 massive sixes, and that's why I said in my previous video of India versus Pakistan that Khushdil Shah, although he was tucked by Hardik Pandya and caught, he's a great talent, he needs time, and my point exactly in this game, he proved it. So well done to Khushdil, and many more innings to come from him. He's a future superstar, as we know that he had turned PSL on his head last season, and this season also he put in a consistent performance, so the Pakistani management need to be patient. Although he will get a couple of failures down the line, his future is pretty bright. Ehsan Khan in 4 overs just gave away 28 runs. He was the pick of the bowlers, I would say, for Hong Kong, although he didn't get a wicket. Mohammad Ghan Zafar was pretty expensive, 4 overs, 38 runs. Especially Mohammad Rizwan took a liking to him, which isn't easy at all for any bowler. Yasin Murtaza, their opener and all-rounder, he also bowled his quota of 4 overs by giving away 36 runs, not acceptable. Ejaz Khan in 3 overs, Pakistani batsman plundered him for 44 runs, so it's a big no-no. But I think it is a learning experience, but quite a painful one. He will understand where to bowl and how to bowl, at which speed to bowl, and at what crucial juncture to use which delivery. So, not to over analyze, but there is a lot of scope of improvement as the figures suggest. आयुष शुक्ला गेव अवे 33 रन्स इन 3 ओवर्स, वंस अगेन गोइंग 11 पर ओवर, ऑल्दो ही इम्प्रेस्ड इन इंडिया. सो ही ऑन क्रिकेट एक्सपर्ट्स ही हैज पुट ऑन अ क्वाइट अ गुड इम्प्रेशन. एंड हारून अर्शद इन 2 ओवर्स ही गेव अवे जस्ट 14 रन्स, कुडन टेक अ विकेट. इट वॉज अ माइंड बॉगलिंग दैट द हांगकॉन्ग स्किपर बाबर हायट डिडंट कम्प्लीट हिज फुल कोटा ऑफ ओवर्स. ही वॉज द लीस्ट एक्सपेंसिव अलॉन्ग विथ एजाज खान. आई डोंट नो वॉट वेंट रॉन्ग एंड दिस हैज बीन द प्रॉब्लम फॉर हांगकॉन्ग इन द फर्स्ट गेम एज वेल, दैट देयर बॉलर्स लीक रन्स फार टू इजिली इन द डेथ ओवर्स, विच इट्स वेरी डिट्रीमेंटल टू द टीम्स चांसेस एंड इट पुट्स ऑल द प्रेशर ऑन द ओपनर्स. एंड दैट्स एक्जैक्टली वॉट हैपन्ड. हांगकॉन्ग वर बंडल आउट फॉर जस्ट 38 इन 10.4 ओवर्स, हैंडिंग पाकिस्तान विक्ट्री बाय 155 रन्स, विच वॉज देयर इजिली द बिगेस्ट मार्जिन इन इंटरनेशनल क्रिकेट और फॉर एनी टीम. नसीम शाह इन 2 ओवर्स टुक 7 रन्स एंड टुक 2 विकेट्स राइट अप द ऑर्डर. आई थॉट दैट ही वॉजंट गोइंग टू प्ले, बट ही हैड रिकवर्ड प्रिटी नाइसली एंड हिज स्पीड वॉज ऑल्सो अप, सो इट इज़ अ गुड साइन. आई थॉट हसन अली वॉज गोइंग टू बी ड्राफ्टेड इन प्लेस ऑफ नसीम शाह, बट मैनेजमेंट स्टक विथ हिम एंड नसीम शाह ऑल्सो पुट इन अ गुड परफॉर्मेंस. शाहनवाज धानी बोल्ड अ मेडन ओवर इन इज कपल ऑफ ओवर्स, 2 ओवर्स 1 मेडन 7 रन्स 1 विकेट. इफ्तिकार अहमद बोल्ड अ सिंगल ओवर विच जस्ट यील्डेड 3 रन्स फॉर हांगकॉन्ग. सो वॉज हरीश राव, इन 1 ओवर ही गेव अवे जस्ट 6 रन्स. शादाब खान वॉज द पिक अप द बॉलर्स इन 2.5 ओवर्स, 2.4 ओवर्स ही गेव अवे 8 रन्स एंड टुक 4 स्कैल्प्स. हांगकॉन्ग बैट्समैन वर एब्सोल्युटली एट सी विथ हिज वेरिएशंस. ही वेरीड हिज पेस प्रिटी नाइसली. ही बोल्ड द बॉल एट अ फुलर लेंथ विच फोर्स द हांगकॉन्ग बैट्समैन टू प्ले द बॉल. एंड आई हैड मेन्शनड इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियोज दैट इन द मैच अगेंस्ट हांगकॉन्ग, इन द आई बेग योर पार्डन, इन द मैच अगेंस्ट बांग्लादेश, अफगानिस्तान बॉलर्स ऑल्सो एम्प्लॉयड द सेम स्ट्रेटजी. बांग्लादेश बॉलर बैट्समैन वर अनेबल टू पिक द बॉल फ्रॉम द हैंड विच वॉज इज अनडूइंग. सो अ टीम लाइक बांग्लादेश विच हैज इयर्स एंड इयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस एट द इंटरनेशनल लेवल कुडंट डू सच बेसिक थिंग्स इन अ राइट मैनर. देर आर एक्चुअली विथ ऑल ड्यू रिस्पेक्ट टू हांगकॉन्ग नो एक्सपेक्टेशन फ्रॉम देम. ऑल्दो शादाब खान स्पीड इज इवन इफ यू रीड हिम ऑफ द पिच इट इज मैनेजेबल इफ यू प्ले सेंसिबली, बट हांगकॉन्ग बैट्समैन डिडेंट डू दैट. शादाब बोल्ड गूगलीज एज वेल विच वर द अनडूइंग ऑफ 3 of the Hong Kong batsmen. They got out on googlies of Shadab Khan. So a lot of work to be done there for Trent Johnson, the head coach. And Mohammad Nawaz put the icing on the cake, 2 overs, 5 runs, 3 wickets. None of the Hong Kong batsmen managed to get into double figures. So that is, I would say, a pretty embarrassing stat for any international team. But as I said, it's a steep and hard learning curve for Hong Kong. And their skipper was also looking pretty sad at the post-match press conference, which you expect, but I expected more from Hong Kong. But this victory now sets up a blockbuster between India and Pakistan on Sunday. So I will make a review in both English and Marathi for that. But a very clinical and a dominant display from Pakistan, and they needed that after a last week, last over defeat against India, which will certainly raise their confidence. This victory for Pakistan. And I hope a crackerjack of a contest take place on Sunday. So how did you like my analysis of this game? Please tell in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for further notifications. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, everyone, bye.